So we've all seen pros bring giant bags full of identical tennis rackets to the court. But as rec players, do we really need to have a pile of perfectly matched frames for success? Many of us are restringing our rackets due to tension loss or strings going dead rather than actually breaking strings. So are backup rackets really that necessary? And if you are going to bother with a second racket, shouldn't it be a different model? Wouldn't it be nice to have like a doubles racket and a singles racket, or one for when you play advanced players and a different one for when you play pushers? Well, like with everything in tennis, it depends. So first, let's take a look at what the pros do, because here we have two main strategies. Strategy A is to keep everything the same. Players like Rafael Nadal are the best examples of this. With few exceptions, Nadal always strings his arrows with RPM Blast 1.35 at 25 kilos or 55 pounds. And he keeps his racket set up the same, regardless of the conditions, the altitude, the temperature, or the weather. The one exception that I know about this was for the 2022 season, where he went to a thinner string and a heavier setup on hard courts before switching back to his thick string, lighter racket setup on clay. On the other hand, strategy B is to change your setups depending on the condition. Many players like Federer or John Isner have spoken about keeping a bag full of rackets strung at different tensions. This way, if the ball is flying on you a little bit because it's hot out, you can just pick up that racket with a tighter tension and gain a little bit of extra control on the court. So I've also heard that Andy Murray actually increases his tension on colder nights or in windy conditions to really force himself to keep hitting through the ball. So already we've got a couple of different approaches. Nadal relies on himself to adjust to the new conditions. Federer adjusts his equipment to the new conditions. Whereas Sir Andy Muzz, the Murray Goat, adjusts both. But for him, it's more about adjusting his equipment to force those changes in his game. And whether or not these adjustments in tension are more of a placebo effect, or if they actually do make a practical difference, could definitely be up to debate. But I don't think that's what really matters here. What matters is that different approaches work for different people, meaning that there is an approach out there that's going to work best for you. But what happens if we take strategy B to the extreme, changing more than just your string tension depending on the condition? One common question that I see both in the comment section in this channel, but also on forums and on Reddit and r/tennis, is about getting a backup racket that's different from your primary racket. Let's say, for example, you've got an Izo 98, which you love, but sometimes it hurts your elbow a little bit, so you whip out your Wilson Clash to kind of cure that tendonitis or whatever is going on. Another scenario could be you've got a pure arrow and you love it, but when you play against weaker opponents, you have a hard time trusting that racket. You can't stay aggressive and maybe you overhit a little bit. So you want a Blade 98 to dial in a little extra control in your game. And finally, there's that classic conundrum of having a doubles racket and a singles racket. I personally never recommend this strategy, and that's coming from a guy who's got how many different kinds of rackets on the wall behind him. Tennis is a very hard sport. Every time I play, even when I'm using my own racket on a regular basis, it feels like I kind of have to relearn my strokes during the warm-up. There are always new things that we have to adjust to. Different opponents, different temperatures, different humidities, new courts, different balls. And my body does not feel the same day to day either. Sometimes I wake up, I'm feeling hungry or sluggish. And other days I feel absolutely elite, like I could be that 4.0 to take a set off Nadal. Even things as trivial as our moods can make a huge difference depending on the day. So if you really care about improving your game, I think minimizing these variables is the key to success. Having to dedicate your brain power to adjusting your game to different rackets takes your mind away from improving your tennis. And over the last few months, I've really been grinding on TennCom, trying to publish as many reviews as possible. But I also want to improve my game. And while I feel like the limiting factor in my tennis is most definitely related to my footwork and leg strength, it's really hard to think about improving those things when I'm also trying to get a feel for all these different rackets. And I have no doubt that making these reviews and starting this channel has made me a worse tennis player on the whole. Having rackets in your mind at all times is simply not great for your tennis. But that doesn't mean it's not fun. I know I'm not going pro, and even though I do want to improve my tennis, it's not the only thing I like about tennis. I love trying new rackets, experimenting with new string setups, and making these videos. So if you have fun with a different backup racket, I think by all means, go for it. But if you think that switching rackets depending on the conditions of the match is really going to lead to sustainable long-term game improvement, it probably won't. There's a reason why pros are so reluctant to switch tennis rackets. It becomes little more than a mere distraction from what's truly holding us back on court. So with all that said, will I stop testing new rackets to focus on my game? Absolutely not. I still love making these reviews and will keep doing it as long as TennCom exists, and will probably fool around with rackets long after that. But I do think I'm gonna scale down the volume of the reviews that I've been working on, at least in the short term, because I've been having a lot of fun trying to improve my game on court these days. Let me know what you think. Do you have a couple of different rackets that you like to experiment with? You all know I do. What's your favorite racket?